You're watching ESPNU College Football presented by Polaris. Welcome to Memorial Stadium in Lincoln, Nebraska, the 330th consecutive sellout as the Illini and Cornhuskers open Big Ten play here in October. Welcome, everybody. Tom Hart alongside John Congemi. There'll be a change for the second consecutive game at quarterback for Nebraska. Taylor Martinez, who holds 37 school records, including total offense, will not play again this week, still suffering from the effects of turf toe. So he has turned it over once again to the freshman, Tommy Armstrong Jr. We'll also see Ron Kellogg III get some snaps for the Huskers.
Tommy's a guy that's a confident quarterback. He's confident in his abilities. He's athletic. He runs the football well. He's a high-energy guy, and I know his offensive coordinator Tim Beck says he has the it factor, and then you have the it factor with Ron Kellogg. He has the experience that you need, maybe not on the field, but he knows his role. He's probably going to play in this football game, Tom, as early as the third series, and then let's see how the rhythm goes on offense to see who continues at quarterback. But I do believe, just as Nebraska has a 1-2 punch at running back, they're going to have a 1-2 punch today at the quarterback position.
Huskers won the toss. They elect to defer. And a very dangerous kickoff returner, Vangelo Bentley, leads the nation in kickoff return average, nearly 38 yards per kick return. And Nebraska is kicking on this windy day into a stiff breeze. So Bentley and Miles Osei will set up shop at the 5-yard line. It's a gorgeous day for football here in America's heartland. It's also a typical fall day. Don't let the sunshine fool you. The temperature will have a hard time reaching the 50s today, and with the breeze, it will feel like it's well into the low 40s. The wind will gust to nearly 30 miles an hour, and maybe we'll see a return to old smash-mouth Nebraska football with a reliance on the run game. Mauro Bondi will kick it off with the hold due to the wind. Bentley won't have a chance for a return. These two programs first met in 1892, and now Nathan Shieldhouse, the senior from Kansas City Rockhurst High School, leads the Illini on the field.
Tommy's been lighting it up early in this season, and he's been doing it with his right arm in the pocket, protecting the football. 12 touchdowns, only 3 interceptions. He's a 3-year starter. He's a smart quarterback, and he's a guy that has a lot of responsibility at the line of scrimmage, meaning changing the plays. So noise and being able to communicate today, going with an empty backfield on first down, will be imperative for the veteran quarterback.
41st career start for Shieldhouse. They go empty, 5 wide to start. 4-man rush for the Huskers, and Shieldhouse finds a man. And a little bit of room for Josh Ferguson as he picks up 4. Ferguson is dangerous out of the backfield. In fact, he leads the nation in receiving yards by a running back with 262 on the season. We expect Illinois to be unconventional today on offense. We'll see plenty of trick plays. And they have some difference makers when it comes to skill position players. As Ferguson motions out there, empty for the second time. Shieldhouse wants to run, and he ran into his own man. Finally wrestled down by the junior college transfer, Randy Gregory. It's a loss of 2 for Nebraska.
Nice job of setting the edge by Randy Gregory. He's going to come to the outside. It looked like Shieldhouse was expecting to go inside. He goes outside right into the arms of Gregory. That's a nice play of just setting the edge and staying outside, trusting the guys that are coming from the inside help. You have youth along that front four and that linebacker crew, but Gregory's one of those sophomores that needs to make an impact today.
They run in a freshman, Greg McMullen, on that front line for Nebraska. They are very young on the defensive side. 3rd and 7 for the Illini. Everybody's covered. Shieldhouse will take it out of bounds. Nathan Shieldhouse was a tremendous runner as a young Illinois quarterback. They have limited his runs this season under Bill Cubitt. He said there's no reason to take a chance for him to get injured. We have other guys who can do that now, but Illinois will go 3 and out on its first possession.
Terrific defensive set of downs for Nebraska to start this football game. They should get excellent field position because, Tom, they're kicking into the wind right now.
Justin Duvernois will kick it away for Illinois. Jordan Westerkamp, a redshirt freshman, is set to return. Duvernois kicking into this stiff breeze here in Lincoln. trying to beat the wind, and that's not what he had in mind, but he'll get an okay roll. And quite frankly, into the wind, punting will be a challenge today. That one goes for just 29 yards. So the Huskers have the wind at their back, and a freshman, Tommy Armstrong Jr., to take over. He was fantastic against the Jackrabbits of South Dakota State. Can he replicate those numbers in the Big Ten?
He was 12 of 15. He was able to complete 80% of his passes. He's confident, he's young, he's high energy, he's a good runner, and he has the it factor, and I think the guys around him really buy in to what he's selling as a quarterback.
Nebraska starts out in the I formation. Amir Abdullah is the I back. Play action on the first play, and Armstrong fires one incomplete, trying to find Kenny Bell. Let's take a look at the impact players this afternoon in this Big Ten tilt.
One of the guys behind Tommy Armstrong is definitely Amir Abdullah, the running back. He has three great games of over 100 yards, terrific vision, and a tough runner. But on the defensive side, Tietzma and Spence. Tietzma is versatile. He has to control that line of scrimmage for the Illini.
This is Armstrong trying to make a man miss. He's past midfield and he fights his way. Abdullah picks up the first down, brought down by Jonathan Brown.
He's only 5'9", 190 pounds, Tom, but this is a guy that runs very tough in between the tackles, and he's a one-cut runner. He's going to see that spot, and he's going to make a move north and south. He's very tough for the first tackler to bring down.
Tommy Armstrong keeps it, and he picks up 2 yards into the gut of that Illinois defense. Jake Howe with the stop. Let's take a look now at Kenjemi's keys.
I think it's a 1-2 punch offensively for Nebraska. With Taylor Martinez out, you're going to need Armstrong and the backup, Ron Kellogg, to make good decisions from the pocket. And for the defense of the Illini, Nebraska's only given up 2 sacks. The Illini have to be able to get to the quarterback and make him throw the football when he's not ready.
And now on 2nd and 8, he completes one, finding his tight end, Jake Long. That's good for a Nebraska first down. One first down on the ground, another through the air. Mason Monheim, a sophomore from Orrville, Ohio, with the stop.
Tom, that's one way to combat a pass rush, is to be able to get the football out on time. You saw Tommy Armstrong just catch the football, make one step, put that back foot in the ground, and the ball's gone on time.
Opening drive for the Huskers. Abdullah slithers his way for 3, a hard-fought 3 yards for the junior from Homewood, Alabama, who grew up an Auburn fan. The Tigers wanted him, but as a defensive back, he's found a home in Nebraska's backfield.
I want to see that evaluation. He looks pretty good with the ball in his hands.
Averaging 116 yards a game. And another crack at it for Abdullah. And room on the edge. He's still free. Amir Abdullah to the pylon. And he is down, marked out at the 3-yard line as Bentley came up with the stop. A gain of 29 on the ground for Amir Abdullah.
Abdullah shows great vision and patience, but terrific blocks at the point of attack. Carter, one of the tight ends, he seals the edge. It's just a good job by this offensive line, who's been a pleasure to watch play this entire season. It's only been 4 games, but they win the battles at the line of scrimmage.
Bo Pelini said it might be the best offensive line they've had here in their time in Lincoln. Abdullah behind that line is hit, but he surges forward for the score. They hit him at the line of scrimmage, and Abdullah powers his way in right through Austin Tietzma.
Power running on the inside. That's a trademark of the Cornhuskers. He's hit at the 2-yard line, just stood up by Tietzma, who's one of those guys that needs to play huge for the Illini up front. But Abdullah shows you that power, that tenacity. 4th touchdown on the year for Amir.
This is Pat Smith to attempt the extra point. And the senior with the win and through the balloons after Nebraska's first score. Pops it through. On this gusty, windy, cool October afternoon, Nebraska has already turned to the running game, and Amir Abdullah has helped it pay off for the Huskers.
ESPNU College Football is presented by Polaris. See the most complete lineup of off-road vehicles at Polaris.com. And in part by Lee, introducing the new Lee Modern Series for men.
Nebraska didn't waste any time. First possession, turning to the ground game, and the Huskers lead Illinois 7-0. What do you like about Amir Abdullah?
He's productive, Tom. The guy is a slasher with great vision, and he's a one-cut runner. When he decides where he's going to go, north and south, he's going to plant that right foot in. Now, look, the defender has leverage to the outside. So what does Amir do? He's going to stick that right foot in the ground and go north and south for a big play. Once he gets in the open field, he has terrific speed. But it's the vision and it's the decision-making when he has that ball tucked under that right arm that makes Nebraska so productive. Now, watch this. He's going to stretch out, follow the lead blocks on the outside, get to the open field. That goes for 30. That gets them down to the 2, and he gets his fourth touchdown of the season. Terrific vision. He's a slasher, but he doesn't hesitate. Once he sees that hole, he's through it and through the back end of it.
He was a 1,000-yard rusher last season and a second-team All-Big Ten honoree, capping a 7-play, 57-yard drive. Mauro Bondi will kick it off for Nebraska. And with that wind, Bentley will take it on the back line and take a knee. So it's another opportunity for Nathan Shielhouse in this Illinois offense.
Tom, I'm sure that offensive coordinator Bill Cubitt right now told his veteran quarterback during that drive by Nebraska, we need to get a couple of first downs. Even if we don't score on this drive, you have to be able to flip the field because of the wind. You can't give Nebraska a short field the way they've proven they could run the football against your defense in that first series.
This is Ferguson. He's great on the edge, and he gets to the perimeter for 9 yards to set up a second and short as we meet the impact players.
Well, Josh Ferguson's going to be one of those guys because he has the speed on the outside. Donovan Young's the guy that's between the tackles. And defensively, David Santos, he's worked himself, he's only a sophomore, back into the starting lineup. He did enough during the week and that off week to get back in that starting lineup and run the defense for the Blackshirts.
Here's some motion and movement for Illinois. And they will hand it off straight ahead to Donovan Young. Young picks up the first down. He's got quite a compliment in Josh Ferguson. You've got the inside runner in Young and the outside guy in Ferguson.
As we just alluded to in the impact players, Donovan Young's dominant inside the tackles. He's powerful. He's a strong runner. And Ferguson's going to be that bounce guy who catches it out of the backfield. But right now, with the formations, you're looking for either between the tackles or play action pass to one of your tight ends.
And Illinois is going with some big formations here early. Young again trying to find some room, and that's maybe a couple of yards on first down as we take a look at Kenjemi's keys.
I always thought looking into this game, the Illini would have to be successful on first down. They're completing 76% of their passes, 6 touchdowns, stay out of the third and long. And for Nebraska defensively, that youth needs to rise up. They have to grow. They have 11 of 16 players on that two deep, either freshmen or sophomores. Guys have to stay disciplined, but they have to know their assignment and play like they're juniors or seniors.
On 2nd and 6, Shielhouse checks. For Young again, and this time he tries to get outside, and he's got a little bit more room inside the 40, and he finally takes it down to the 35. The ball came loose. Nebraska has it. Leroy Alexander, the freshman from Toledo, rises from the turf with the football in his hands. And while the Blackshirts have been maligned on yardage, they do have some takeaways, and that's another for Nebraska as the officials converge.
First down.
Bill Lamonier, this Big Ten crew, is our white hat today.
Tom, one of those young players that happens to get on the football. It looked like it was ripped out by Corey Cooper, the safety. I'm not so sure if he was on the ground or not, but that ball's ripped out by Cooper, and Alexander, the guy that gets on it for Nebraska's defense. I don't know if the elbow's down and then the ball comes out.
Well, the knees were down before the elbows, so as they take another look at it in the replay booth here at Tom Osborne Field, gives us a chance to give another look.
That was a heck of a run by Donovan Young, just staying patient to the left side. But let's watch the end of the run. It looks like Cooper, number six, is going to be the guy trying to strip the football out. I'm not so sure if he wasn't down before that ball comes out. Let's see if it pops out loose before anything hits the ground here. It looks like it's on the way out before he hits the ground. The ball changes position.
The key should be the right hip of Donovan Young.
If it's down, it looks like the ball's coming out before that hip touches the ground. I think that play's going to stand.
And as always, they're looking for indisputable video evidence to overturn the call on the field. Here's Bill Amanye.
Video review, the play stands as called. First down, Nebraska.
It's the 11th takeaway for this Nebraska defense, and it comes at a perfect time with the Illini driving.
And although Young and in this offense were productive in that second drive, they cough it up, but at least they give Nebraska 70 yards to try to hit pay dirt here on their second possession.
Tommy Armstrong wants to throw. A beautiful pass completed past midfield to Quincy Anunua, and it's a Nebraska first down, a gain of 26.
Clean pocket for Armstrong to deliver a strike down the middle, and that's just way too easy on the Illini defense. Nobody even close in the pocket or in coverage down the field. Ernest Thomas was trying to close that gap, but he was nowhere near the catch.
This is Amani Cross in his first carry of the game, and he pushes towards the 40, a pickup of nearly three on first down. Jonathan Brown, sixth in the nation in tackles, leading the Big Ten with 11.8 a game, came up with a stop for the Illini. That will leave second and seven for Nebraska.
Well, those two linebackers have to play at a high tempo for the Illini defensively, and Pelini likes what he sees out of his young quarterback so far.
On the fake end around, Armstrong has a little bit of room but couldn't get the edge. Brown was there to bring him down. It will be a first down for Nebraska. Bo Pelini in his sixth season as the head man has won 71% of his games, but it's been a tough season both on and off the field, the former defensive coordinator. This is Cross pushing his own man out of the way and tripped up at the 20-yard line. Taylor Barton did just enough to get Amani Cross to the turf.
And Illinois' lucky Cross stumbled once he got into the secondary because he was one cut from taking it in for 6 points. Nice patient run by Cross, the sophomore out of Gainesville, Georgia. He makes one man miss. He's in the end zone.
Nebraska going tempo now. The ball's put on the turf by Cross on the easy toss. And he has to fall on it for a loss of 3 yards. How does that happen if you're a running back?
Sometimes your eyes move up on the field when it's that short toss, and I think that Cross's eyes went off the football and to where he was going. That's the first negative play Nebraska's had offensively. Kind of breaks their rhythm up. Let's see if the young quarterback Armstrong on second and long can get some of that yardage back.
To throw, incomplete, another high toss. And there may be a reason why Tommy Armstrong misses high with his passes, and that's that lingering knee issue in his left leg.
He had it cleaned out during training camp, but it's one of those injuries that you really can't, when you plant on that right foot and you're trying to throw on your left foot, you have to distribute that weight. And I'm not so sure Tommy's completely convinced that he can open up that left toe, plant hard on that left leg and deliver and come off of the right foot to throw more accurately down the field. When he misses high because his shoulders are tilted up towards the sky instead of parallel to the ground.
And it's the second time he's missed high today. Empty backfield, wants to throw again, and that is complete. Taking it past the marker is Amir Abdullah. A first down for Nebraska, first and goal coming.
Attaway, Tommy, comes back after throwing to a wide open wide receiver and Kenny Bell and missing him. He comes back and stands tall in the pocket. Now watch his balance in the pocket this time. Just a short step, doesn't really follow through, but he has a strong enough arm to zip it outside to Abdullah. Takes a little shot after that too.
Toss to Cross, holds on this time. And dragged down from behind, no horse collar. Jonathan Brown had his jersey. His hand was not inside the pan, inside the pads.
Take a look at that left hand. It looked like he just had a handful of jersey. He didn't go inside the shoulder pads, so therefore no call on the play. Good aggressive play by Jonathan Brown coming downhill, the leader in tackles for that Illini defense.
A loss of one. Second and goal.
Always have to be careful moving the pocket when you have a quarterback that is good with his feet here inside the red zone.
Cross. Wrestled down inside the five by Jonathan Brown. Brown, the senior from Memphis out of Christian Brothers High School, has already been busy today. He's once again healthy for the Illini defense. Last year, as a Butkus Award semifinalist about midway through the season, he had to deal with a shoulder injury that limited his time. Only 59 tackles. He'll be at that before the end of the day today. Play action. Into the end zone, caught. Quincy Enunwa with the touchdown reception. And Nebraska's got a two-touchdown lead.
Offensive coordinator Tim Beck and head coach Bo Pelini could not have scripted this game any better for their young quarterback making his second start. Takes the Cornhuskers right down the field on the opening set of downs, and he does it again and finds Enunwa for 6 points.
Pat Smith's extra point is good. That is a 10-play drive capped with the touchdown pass from Tommy Armstrong Jr. His second career touchdown pass, maybe the first of many for the freshman out of Texas.
You're watching Tailgate Week, fired up by Kingsford Charcoal.
Is this not the perfect tailgate week? I mean, yeah, you can do the McMuffins on the grill, but this is an ideal chili day here in the Midwest, is it not?
Tom, we missed that invite right there. I'm disappointed we didn't get to partake in that. That looks like a lot of fun.
We can crash a party or two post-game.
We've been known to do that. That's true.
Husker faithful, some of the best in college football, the 330th consecutive sellout. It started on homecoming against Missouri in 1962. This is homecoming here in Lincoln this season. And today, the Huskers aren't a program that traditionally schedules cupcakes for homecoming. Wisconsin and Ohio State each of the last two seasons, as the alums are welcome back. Wind will carry this one deep in the end zone once again. Bentley, the nation's best, hasn't had a chance for a return. Let's take a look back with our tire rack drive recap. And it started on a defensive takeaway for Nebraska.
Nebraska doing everything they have to do offensively. Enunwa gets it to the outside. Then you have Cross coming in inside the tackle, showing some good footwork, and then a nice pass by Armstrong to the outside to Abdullah, and then good pocket presence again. He finds Enunwa. That's at least one pass reception in each of his last 18 games, all led by the freshman making his second start.
Third possession for Illinois. Josh Ferguson is the tailback. John Davis, the tight end, moves to fullback after the shift. Nathan Shieldhouse wants the throw, and he checks it right back to his tight end Davis, and he's got room. They do such a good job releasing running backs to the flat in this pass game, which kind of turns into a run game in many ways.
Tom, if there's one play that could have went the distance, it was this. This is a terrific call by Bill Cuban. All the flow is going to the wide side of the field. Those linemen are right out in front. It's a picket line going down the Nebraska sideline, but the ball couldn't get out to the receiver quick enough, and Nebraska is able to run it down from behind.
This is Ferguson. He's got room on the right side. And Ferguson stretches it to midfield before being brought down by David Santos, who got the start at middle linebacker today in place of Josh Banderas, the freshman from Lincoln.
We talked about the impact that Young and Ferguson will have on this Illini offense. You really like what you see. Donovan Young's a power guy. Ferguson there shows you the elusiveness on the edge.
Trying to go straight ahead. And a first down carry for Ferguson. Corey Cooper with the stop. Couple of Illinois players there. Cooper is from Maywood, Illinois, out of Proviso East. And Ferguson from Naperville.
If there was ever a chance to go play action and try one over the top, it's right now as you cross the 50. Little play action. You got everybody bunched in there and try to hit one over the top.
Spencer Harris, the only wide receiver split out. He'll keep it on the ground. And nowhere to go for Ferguson. That will be a loss of one. Michael Rose is a redshirt freshman out of Kansas City and out of Nathan Shieldhouse's program, Rockhurst High School.
Another one of those young players for Bo Pelini. He talked about the youth on defense to us yesterday. Some of those guys rising up. Alexander with a fumble recovery. That time, Rose coming in with a big play.
All the checks on the line are left to Nathan Shieldhouse, the fifth-year senior. Second and 11. On the ground. And Ferguson with the carry to set up third and short. Let's take it back to the studio now and Dari.
All right, Tom, thank you. It is time now for our Dr. Pepper 10 conference update. We go to the ACC. Florida State strikes first against Maryland. Fourth straight game with a rushing touchdown for Carlos Williams. 7-0 Seminoles, Steph.
Big play here, third and two for Illinois. Shieldhouse dumps it out of the backfield, and that will be a first down and more coming for Ferguson, who works way down the sideline. Finally wrestled out of bounds by Stanley Jean Baptiste.
Tom, that's a tough matchup between Josh Ferguson and David Santos, the linebacker. He's the middle linebacker, and it's an option route. Everybody's going to clear out and leave it underneath for Josh Ferguson. He's either going to break inside or break outside. And the key was by Nathan Shieldhouse. He didn't throw a bullet. He threw a catchable pass for Ferguson to catch and then turn up field for the first down.
Three tight ends on the field for Illinois. Donovan Young is the tailback. Little misdirection, and Young gets a block at the edge, but still can't swing by Corey Cooper, who's able to fight off that block. A pickup of two for Donovan Young out of Houston's Katy High School.
Imperative on this drive for the Illini to come away with some points, either a field goal or to try to get it in the end zone to make this a one touchdown game.
Field goal will be tough into the wind, which has been gusting to nearly 30 miles an hour out of the southwest. Toss to Young. Blockers in front. So are a bunch of red jerseys, and the first one there brings them down. That's Michael Rose. Well, we asked Bo Pelini about the challenge of playing so many freshmen on the defensive side. He said it's not their body type, it's more the mind, to get them to execute their assignment and be consistent with it.
You have to be able to have great eye discipline in this defense, and eye discipline for a very short time, which Bo was trying to explain to us yesterday. Those guys are doing a good job initially, but when they recognize they need to get off of some of those blocks and be able to create plays, create turnovers, be able to create more bodies at the point of attack. do your job, and just do your job, but make sure your eye discipline is getting to the football.
Shieldhouse under pressure, and he's brought down from behind by Jason Ankra. That will bring up fourth down for Illinois, and a stiff breeze. It'll be tough to kick it from here.
And they're going to have to go for this, I believe, with that loss on third down. This is a good job of staying in the pocket initially, but it breaks down, and good penetration by Ankra. He's one of those guys that is a veteran on that defensive front, starting to lead with his hard work, and it's starting to show up on Saturdays.
It would be a 45-yard field goal attempt from here into the wind, which is coming out of the south-southwest. Small sample size for Illinois on their fourth down conversions, but it will be a timeout used by Nebraska. 14-0 Huskers. Illinois trying to go for it on fourth down when we return. ESPNU's college football continues later today at 3:30. The Yellow Jackets have a major ACC Coastal Division matchup against the fourth-ranked Hurricanes. Then at 7, with both teams sitting at 3-1, the Rebels go on the road to face the Tigers on the Plains. ESPNU's college football today at 3:30 and 7 on ESPNU. Both games also live on Watch ESPN. 10th play of the drive. 4th and 11 for Illinois and quarterback Nathan Shieldhouse. They've emptied the backfield, 5 wide. Plenty of time. Shieldhouse over the middle. And a big hit. Jars the ball loose. It is ruled incomplete. Steve Hall was the intended receiver. He got it on his hands, and then it popped right out on a big hit from the Nebraska secondary. Andrew Green was the man in coverage.
And that's a guy that has switched from cornerback to one of the safeties. Just a crossing route. You're going to get an under and then an over. The over's there, but the ball just a touch behind, and that's nice timing and recognition. Good pop on the play. That's just a good timing on the play. That was Stanley Jean Baptiste who comes up with a big pop in the secondary. Good recognition by the Cornhuskers.
Ron Kellogg is now in at quarterback for Nebraska, as we suspected, and taken down after a gain of 4 is Amir Abdullah. So Tommy Armstrong Jr., the redshirt freshman, gives way to Kellogg, a senior from Omaha's Westside High School, appearing in his 7th game.
This is just all part of the plan by Bo Pelini and offensive coordinator Tim Beck to get their senior Ron Kellogg into the football game. It's a luxury being up 14-0.
Kellogg wants to throw. The blitz comes, and he finds a hole in the Illinois defense, and Kenny Bell has a first down grab. Kellogg was 8 of 9 for 136 yards against South Dakota State and saw action in the second half against Southern Miss, 4 of 5 for 24 yards. First quarter comes to an end. Offense not an issue for Nebraska, and the defense coming up big today. A takeaway and a huge fourth quarter stop, fourth down stop, pardon me. But once again, it's Nebraska's offense which has paved the way. Amir Abdullah leading the way, and it's 14-0 Huskers. Great fans here in Lincoln, Nebraska, but they haven't seen Illinois up close and personal for a while. It's the Illini's first visit here since 1985. In fact, they've only met twice in the last 60 years. And the last time Illinois won a game here at Memorial Stadium, or at least here in Lincoln, they had a running back by the name of Red Grange. That was 1924, a year after Illinois' national championship season. 11th meeting of the series, which began all the way back in 1892. Tim Beckman, in his second season as the Illinois head coach, he came to Champaign-Urbana from Toledo, and he said he learned the value of being unpredictable on offense from a matchup with Boise State. He said, I learned how tough it was to prepare for everything that Boise did and realized maybe that could be of value to us. And so their offense is very unpredictable. It's a little bit unconventional, and it's looked good today, with the exception of a key fumble and, of course, the inability to complete and convert that fourth down. Kellogg hands it off, and he carried out the fake very well. So it's a first down carry for Terrell Newby, freshman from Los Angeles. Zane Petty with the stop for Illinois.
And that's the third running back we've seen from Nebraska be productive on that play. Abdullah started it off, Imani Cross, and now Newby comes in right to left and sets the edge, gets outside with that nice speed, and it results in 86 total rushing yards for Nebraska.
It's the first series for Kellogg, and he wants to dial over the middle. Complete. A first down to Quincy Enunwa. Second big catch of the day for Enunwa. This one goes for 30.
Terrific patience in the pocket by Ron Kellogg. He's going to want to go inside to the first post route. He decides he likes it better to the outside, but credit the offensive line. That gave him terrific time in the pocket to go from his first read on the inside and find Enunwa to the outside.
Kellogg had a great camp. He was clearly the number two guy in camp when Armstrong was bothered by a knee issue. This is Newby again, and Newby cuts it inside the defender to go inside the 10. Jonathan Brown with the stop with Zane Petty.
This is a nice job on the outside. In the beginning, he wants to go down the seam, but he didn't like it, so he decides to go to the double post on the outside. This is just good recognition by the quarterback. He didn't like it inside with the bracket coverage. He knew he had single coverage on the outside. Enunwa had inside leverage, so he's able to throw that football on a line and get Nebraska inside of the red zone.
This is Abdullah back on the field, but Kellogg kept it, and he got upended for a loss of one. Third down for Nebraska, needing seven for the first down. Already a big game for Jonathan Brown, the Illini's leader on defense.
I wouldn't be surprised if you saw Jamal Turner. He's in the slot, number 10. Try to attack the middle of the football field with the safeties outside the hashes.
Kellogg wants to throw on the play action, and incomplete. He had a man wide open, Enunwa, and threw it just a little bit behind him.
And Enunwa knew he had what he wanted. Kellogg, that wind can play havoc even though you're going into it. It can get knocked down, and that's exactly what happened. That was good. Good job by Monheim, the linebacker, to get in that passing lane and made it a tough window for Kellogg to try to fit that football through.
This is Pat Smith to attempt the field goal. Only one attempt so far today. The holder is Sam Fultz, a 27-yard attempt. And it is good. First score for the special teams today. Nebraska leads Illinois 17-0. When we return, we'll go way up high to show you another special teamer and a shout out from space when we return to Lincoln. Illinois' Viangelo Bentley leads the nation in kickoff return average. He's got a special fan way up above us. It's former Illini defensive back and NASA astronaut Mike Hopkins.
Hey, Vangelo Bentley, congratulations on being special teams player of the game against Miami of Ohio. Special teams are near and dear to my heart, and I love seeing a guy making such big contributions. And for the rest of the team, good luck this weekend against Nebraska. Huge game, you're starting Big Ten play. Play hard, give it everything you got, and I look forward to watching the game this weekend. See you guys.
Mike Hopkins was on John Makovic's squad at Illinois. He was a walk-on. He ended his career as a captain. They launched from Kazakhstan on September 25th. 6 hours later, he arrived at the International Space Station. Can you get home that quickly tonight?
No, I don't think so. That's got me beat by a couple hours, that's for sure.
Hopkins earned his degree in aerospace engineering from Illinois, got his master's in the same from Stanford. He's a colonel with the United States Air Force and one of 14 members of the 20th NASA astronaut class. That is not the newest football you'll see in action today, but for Nebraska, it's by design.
It really is. I was teasing yesterday. I think they don't know what a new football is out here because they are so comfortable using the worn ones, and it actually helps the skill guys, the receivers, the quarterbacks, the running backs, on a day like this where it's very windy. And I'm sure it helps the kicking
team.
And
the kickers love it. This is Bentley with his first chance today from the goal line. And the nation's leader gets out to the 19, but there's a flag on the play. Will Richards with the special team stop for Nebraska. Here's Bill Lemonnier for the second time today.
Holding, number 52 on the return. Half the distance from the spot of the foul. First down.
A couple of years ago, I grabbed Bill Lemonnier outside of the stadium at Purdue. I said, Bill, I want to make sure I pronounce your name correctly. He said, it's easy. When I make a good call, it's Lemonnier. If it's a bad call, it's Smith.
He hasn't been Smith so far today.
Big Ten crew doing a fantastic job as always. And Nathan Schilhouse trying to get back to work. Illinois has been its own worst enemy today. They turned the ball over with a fumble after a long drive, and then Schilhouse was sacked on third down and threw incomplete on fourth.
And Tom, you finally get the wind at your back and you start inside your own 10-yard line.
Schilhouse has had time most of the afternoon, and this is Ferguson, who is slippery, and he picks up 10, perhaps with the extra effort after staying alive on the sideline. Corey Cooper, who had 10 tackles and a sack against South Dakota State, had the stop for Nebraska.
Tom, it's very evident. You can see why Ferguson leads the country from the running back position in receiving yards. This guy's electric once he gets his hands on the football in the passing game.
Lacoste is the dangerous tight end lined up behind Evan Wilson on the left side of the formation. They haven't passed to the tight ends yet. And another big burst from Ferguson, and he has the sideline again. Pushed out of bounds by Ciante Evans. We're seeing what makes Ferguson so special. It's when he gains the edge.
And when Ferguson sees this play tomorrow, he's going to wish he cut inside right there on the edge, because there's no one in a red shirt that was going to catch him. If he cuts with his left foot and goes to the inside, I think he's got 6 points.
Nebraska uses its second timeout here with Illinois trying to put something together again. Bo Pelini coaching and teaching on the Nebraska sideline.
ESPNU College Football, brought to you by the Discover It Card. It's a game changer.
Well, when most of us are working through our first coffee, the Nebraska players are going through their typical team breakfast on game day. That's pasta, corn, chicken, and steak. And an early start here at 11 a.m. here in Lincoln. They don't serve meals like that where I get my coffee.
No. That looks pretty good. And you know, when you got a lot of mouths to feed on that sidelines with the walk-on program and all the guys that are wearing proudly the Nebraska jersey.
About 120 guys on this Nebraska roster currently. Donovan Young is the tailback here. First down for Illinois. A lot of responsibility for Schilhouse, who checks again. Young. Hit in the backfield and nowhere to go. The timeout worked wonders for Bo Pelini, Nebraska. Jared Afalava, the redshirt freshman from Salt Lake City area, with the stop.
And Tom, that's exactly who Bo was talking to on the sidelines. He was encouraging him, but he was saying, you need to take a better angle. You need to be able to get outside leverage and make that ball carrier run inside. And I think that was a nice correction during that TV timeout by head coach Bo Pelini.
Good protection again, and that pass is complete. but right into the defender. Martiz Barr had the catch. Andrew Green had the hit. A pickup of two, and that'll set up a third and long for the Illini.
Possibly just a little late coming out of the pocket. That ball, if it's delivered a touch earlier, it's going to give Barr an opportunity to square up and possibly make a move on Andrew Green. But Green closes the cushion, and also Nebraska is closing down on third down with a third and long presented in the lap of Nathan Schuhlhaus.
Nebraska's been good on third down this season. They haven't been great. Pressure from the edge. Schuhlhaus will want to run, and he has the first down with the scramble and into Nebraska territory. Stanley Jean Baptiste finally met him and took him out of bounds.
Schuhlhaus hasn't run much in 2013, but when he has, he's been productive in doing it. The Illini may have gotten away with a hold on the left side, but it wasn't called. And Schuhlhaus knows what to do when he has open green turf in front of him.
As a freshman, he ran for 868 yards. Swinging it out to Barr this time, and Martez Barr knifes his way inside the 30 for a first down. Santos with the stop. Schuhlhaus, as a runner, as a freshman, was a true dual threat quarterback. He was recruited by Mike Locksley. They're going to spread out the formation again and create some space for Ferguson. And this is where this offense becomes a little bit unpredictable when they spread out their tackles to either side.
And here comes more tempo in the same formation.
Stojanovic is spread to the left. Lewis spread to the right. And they're going to go right up the middle and brought down by Randy Gregory is Ferguson once again.
When you play the Illini, you have to be able to survive the gadget play. You have to always be on alert, and that's what Bo Pelini was talking to us. They did a nice job of not allowing the big play, and it looks like Gregory having a difficult time trying to make it to his feet.
Gregory is a first-year player from Fishers, Indiana, out of Arizona Western Community College. He didn't show up to campus until late in the summer. He's on the left side of your screen.
He's right here. It looks like he's having problems trying to get to the play on the inside. You mentioned the sophomore. He has to keep that outside leverage. His leg just looked like that left leg may have buckled right underneath it.
Gregory had an interception return for a touchdown against South Dakota State. It was the first for a Nebraska defensive lineman since a guy by the name of Ndamukong Suh had one against Colorado in 2008. It's tough to miss Suh with a giant picture of him in his own weight room here at Nebraska.
Yeah, it's one of those players that it's hard to miss wherever he goes in Suh, but this is a guy in Gregory that's one of those young players Bo Pelini's counting on. You mentioned the pick six. He has five tackles for loss, so he's been active behind the offensive line of scrimmage, so someone's going to have to step up. Probably another young player on that defensive side going to have to step up. Looks like Avery Moss replacing Gregory.
Play action. Schuhlhaus with the wind at his back will instead run. A pump fake will create some space, and he gets taken down in the open field on a nice tackle by Afalava. He's come up big on this drive. Illinois moving with the win now, and a big difference as they are able to have it at their back here in the second quarter.
Well, they need to answer. They need to answer with 6 points. They have to find a way to get this football in the end zone.
On the read, it's handed off to Young, who takes it inside, or to the five, I should say. Leroy Alexander with the stop.
That's called running behind your pads. This is a powerful running back. The junior, he's 6 foot, 220 pounds out of Houston, Texas. Watch him lower that right shoulder.
And quick tempo once again. Nowhere to go for Young, this time going backwards. Ciante Evans with the hit from his cornerback spot.
This is where you rely on a veteran quarterback, a guy that's played plenty of snaps, a three-year starter, to make good decisions inside of the red zone. This is a defense that has allowed a lot of points this year. They have to find a way to keep Schuhlhaus in this offense from converting this drive into 6 points.
Illinois wants a timeout to discuss it. Looking at a second and goal. Illini trying to find the end zone for the first time today, trailing 17-0.
Visit WatchESPN.com or download the WatchESPN app to watch ESPN live anytime, anywhere. Brought to you by Vizio.
Crystal clear day here in Lincoln, Nebraska, as Nathan Shieldhouse and the Illini offense look to convert on second and goal. Donovan Young is the running back. Now joined in the backfield by Davis. Play action, Shieldhouse looking, end zone, caught, but out of bounds. Matt Lacoste couldn't get his toe down, and that will set up third and goal. Corey Cooper had the coverage.
That was nice coverage by Cooper and Green. Had him high and low. This is a good throw on the outside. Only place you could put it was high and over the top of the coverage, but that right foot just touches too much white. Couldn't get that foot down. Matt Lacoste, 6'6", trying to get that big frame in the back of the end zone. Now third and goal for the Illini.
And now four wide receivers on the field. They're tall tight ends. Two of them at 6'6", take a seat.
In Nebraska defensively, you always have to worry about quarterback run.
Here comes the blitz. Shieldhouse dropped all the way back outside the 20. Siante Evans was the first of many. A loss of 11 yards as Nebraska brought the pressure. The game plan said they could only bring pressure on third down, and that's what they pulled off here.
John, defensive coordinator John Papuchas does a nice job of bringing the house. You mentioned Evans on the outside. He does a great job of just coming from the outside and keeping the leverage, keeping the quarterback inside out. And the black shirts come up big on third and goal.
37-yard attempt for Taylor Zaleski. And it is perfect to put Illinois on the scoreboard. Officially 38 for Zaleski. Nebraska's defense has been highly criticized this season once again, but it has come up with some big plays today. The takeaway to thwart Illinois' second drive, the huge stop after the third down sack. They forced an incompletion and then the sack there to put Illinois into field goal range.
Turnovers and creating those turnovers, Tom, hasn't been the problem for Nebraska defensively. They have one today. They have 11 total. They've done a nice job of rallying to the football. It's been the big plays. It's been the gashing runs right up the middle of the defense, and it's been by lesser opponents. So when you're defensive coordinator John Papuchas, you have to find answers to that. And Bo Pelini's one of those guys that are going to help him find answers. And I think it's time for those youthful defensive linemen and linebackers to start playing like it's their fifth, sixth, seventh game of the year and being able to come up and rally and get the scheme and just do their job. Sometimes when you're young, you think you can make all types of plays, but if you just kind of do your assignment and don't think about making the big play, I think the scheme takes over for you defensively.
Well, Nebraska has outgained Illinois by 22 yards, 188 to 166, yet those big stops have helped the Huskers to a two-touchdown lead. Zaleski will employ a holder here. Eaton Spence will put his finger on the football, kicking with the wind. Amir Abdullah has returned to the kickoff return team for Nebraska. He was sensational in that role last season. He's back with Kenny Bell. A short kick even with the wind. Bell from the three. And he takes it out to the 28-yard line. With only seven races left, NASCAR's best continue the drive for the championship. Points leader Matt Kenseth looks to hold off Jimmy Johnson and Kyle Busch for the top spot. It's round four in the chase for the Sprint Cup. The NASCAR Sprint Cup Series at Kansas, presented by Dodge Durango, Sunday at 1 on ESPN, also live on Watch ESPN, or you could follow us to the Omaha Airport today if you like speed.
You'll get all the speed you want today, about 3:15, 3:30.
So here's Nebraska's offense once again with Tommy Armstrong returning at quarterback. And Armstrong wants to keep it, but he loses a couple of yards. Jonathan Brown nearing double digits in tackles, and we're midway through the second quarter. He's got nine, including two. Make that three now behind the line of scrimmage.
Well, clearly Jonathan Brown's the leader of this defense. He's the guy that keeps everybody on their toes. He's the guy that raises the bar, and he's raising it today. You mentioned three times behind the line of scrimmage. Look for the football, you'll find 45.
Abdullah with a stutter step created some space, and he's ridden out of bounds by Taylor Barton. Pickup of 10 for Amir Abdullah, and that'll set up third and two for Nebraska.
Both of these offenses, Tom, you have to be able to block on the perimeter, whether you're a tight end split out and flexed out or a wide receiver. You have backs that can break tackles and make moves in the open field. You have to be able to block on the outside.
Trying to roll the pocket, and that is complete to Anunua. He's got the sideline and a huge block. Only got him a couple extra yards, but it was a head turner from Jamal Turner. Pickup of 19.
Just what we were talking about. Sometimes you're going to get an opportunity to catch the football. Sometimes you're going to be able to provide a block. And that time, Jamal Turner gets that head in front. This is a good adjustment to the football by Anunua, but the block is a blur coming from left to right.
He de-cleated Zane Petty. They roll it again, and that one is complete after a bobble as Nebraska is able to find their powerful tight end who moves his way down the sideline. Sam Cotton, the redshirt freshman tight end, with a 15-yard rumble to move the chains for the Huskers.
That's a nice job by a big body on the outside. And Tommy Armstrong just continues to lead by example. 6 of 8, 90 yards, has the touchdown on the afternoon. And the redshirt freshman making his second start looks very comfortable at the quarterback position.
And this Nebraska offense looks comfortable. Toss sweep out of the eye. Abdullah takes it down nearly to the 21. 17-3 here. Let's check in once again with Dari in the studio.
All right, guys, let's check in on the Big Ten. Penn State has never lost to Indiana in 16 meetings, down 7-0. Christian Hackenberg to Allen Robinson. He does the rest of it. 7-7 in the second, guys, right now in Bloomington.
Well, Allen Robinson is a fun wide receiver to watch. They put him in spots to succeed. They want to throw the ball on the halfback toss, and it is incomplete. Abdullah was getting pressured by T.J. Neal. What do you teach a running back in that situation, in that play call?
Well, you have to look natural. That time it didn't look natural. Abdullah kind of ducks. And that's not really the technique when he runs the football, but you don't want to force the football. There's two or three white jerseys down there, and Abdullah's lucky that ball was just knocked down by the wind. It didn't look like he got everything he wanted on it, but that was good fortune on the play.
Armstrong out of the shotgun. We'll check with the sideline. One of the guys sending in signals will be Taylor Martinez. Option pitch. This is Abdullah. And he pops forward inside the 10.
I like offensive coordinator Tim Beck. He gets back to saying, let's see what Abdullah does well. He does well running the football, not throwing it. And he does an excellent job of taking that inside the 10-yard line. But it looked like Jeremiah Searles was hit by his own player on the play. It looked like Abdullah may have gotten him in the knee.
Offensive coordinator Tim Beck said this is the most consistent offensive line this staff has had since they've been in Lincoln. Searles, a senior from Lakewood, Colorado, in his 45th career game, getting attention from the athletic training staff here at Nebraska. .528 to go before the half here in Lincoln, 17-3 Nebraska. Searles has exited the game, replaced by Brent Qualley after taking this hit to the midsection by Ernest Thomas III. We have yet to see an offensive lineman get the benefit of the targeting rule.
He's going to be back on the football field, but he's getting harassed a little bit on the sidelines by his teammates.
Armstrong, the quarterback, Abdullah, the running back. Armstrong wants to keep it. A stiff arm will get him a few more. Back to the line of scrimmage, Ernest Thomas with the open field tackle for the Illini.
Last time in this situation, Nebraska spreading out the football field, trying to get it to that big play wide receiver, Quincy Anunua, on the outside.
Wide open receiver will take it inside the five. Kenny Bell stopped it near the two. Jalen Dunlap, freshman from Chicago, with the tackle.
Nebraska has weapons at the wide receiver position. When you take Anunua and Bell and Turner, it might be the best three they've had over a number of years, as we see Searles coming back into the lineup.
Anunua has three big catches today, including one for a touchdown. They're going to jam it up, go jumbo here, and go straight ahead for the touchdown. Amani Cross plunges in, and the Huskers extend their advantage on the sixth rushing touchdown of the season for Cross.
Nice tempo, nice play design by offensive coordinator Tim Beck. He goes four wide on the previous play. He brings in the big package. There was no secret where Amani Cross was running that football. That's just imposing your will on a defense. And Cross goes in for the third score.
Capping a 71-play drive for Nebraska. And Pat Smith chunks it right. His second missed point after attempt this season. Bo Pelini can't believe it. It's good to go jumbo. Nebraska, after this completion to Kenny Bell, did just that with all the big fellas up front, and Cross taking it in. $90,458 inside Memorial Stadium, third largest city, if you will, in Nebraska on game day, and the Sea of Red likes what they see. A 20-point lead for the home team on homecoming.
Passionate fan base here in Lincoln, and it's fun to watch their team come out and play the way they want to play.
That guy's got your hat.
He does. I have to get that back before I take my trip back to Fort Lauderdale.
Yeah, 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 woo, let's go.
Extra shoes in abundance here in Lincoln. Bentley from about the two. The nation's leader in kickoff return yardage makes it out to the 21-yard line. 20-point lead here. Let's go back to the studio.
All right, guys. Dari Noka here. Kevin Carter going to join me at halftime. We got plenty of Big Ten to talk about. Penn State, Indiana. How about Michigan State, Iowa? Much of us expected like a 5-3 game. No, it's scoring explosion right now at Kinnick, guys. We'll also get you ready for Ohio State and Northwestern.
All right, Dari, thanks. And we're hearing Jerry Kill suffered another seizure this morning, and Minnesota's head coach will not coach today as the Gophers take on Michigan this afternoon on ABC. We certainly wish Coach Kill the best and a speedy recovery. That program knows how to deal with that, though, even though it might be very scary to outsiders. The players certainly know what he deals with on a regular basis. Josh Ferguson is the running back, play action, and Shieldhouse once again getting time before being flushed. Shieldhouse will scramble, and he gets dragged down, and there's a flag as Afalava took him down a good step and a half onto the white boundary. We'll show the play again, but I also want to ask you, as Bill Lamagne.
Dead ball, unnecessary roughness. Number 33, late hit, out of bounds. 15-yard penalty, first down.
I also want to ask you, how good has Nebraska's secondary coverage been after this replay?
And they've been very good. Let's take another look. He's clearly in bounds, but he's giving himself up. So if you're the defender right there, all you need to do is ride the quarterback out of bounds. And when you take him to the ground 5 yards out of the field of play, that's always going to draw a penalty flag.
First flag against Nebraska this afternoon. Chilhouse lobs one incomplete, aiming for Martez Barr. Coverage by Andrew Green.
Tom, the answer to that first question about the secondary is they're sticking down the field because you've got a quarterback in Nathan Chilhouse that will buy time, not only in the pocket, but outside of the pocket.
Quick hitter again, and Chilhouse scrambling once again. You know, that's what makes it so tough on a personal foul, because he could have given himself up, but as a running quarterback, he lowered his shoulder. So
time,
as a defender.
Well, that's the difference. The other time, he didn't. And as a defender, you have to be able to ride him. But go ahead, you can make the initial hit, but don't take him down to the ground. Make the initial hit, but don't take the quarterback down to the ground.
Third and four, he looks for the slant, and it's incomplete. Ryan Lankford was the intended receiver. And that will bring up fourth and four. And Illinois' offense, which came into this game scoring 40 points a game, 25th in the nation, has been held to three so far in the first half. Justin Duvernois will come on to punt for Illinois. And wait till you hear how Duvernois became a punter. 29-yarder into the wind in the first quarter. Now he's got the wind at his back. Westerkamp takes it over his shoulder at the 10. There's a flag on the play, and he takes it out to the 15. As we wait for this Big Ten crew to give us a call, tell us how Justin Duvernois ended up a punter.
Well, Justin, I had the opportunity to coach him at St. Thomas Aquinas High School down in Fort Lauderdale when he was a freshman and sophomore in the JV team, and we couldn't find a position for him. I mean, he's 6'1", 190 pounds as a freshman. So you feel like, well, maybe he's a tight end. We can move him to tight end. We threw him a few passes. It didn't go real well.
Filling black on the back, number 19. Half the distance, spot of the foul. First down.
Then we moved him to defensive end. We figured, you know, with his range, he might be able to get his hands up in the passing lanes. That was worse. So when Justin came back and he was shagging punts for our initial punter, when he was catching him and kicking him back, they were going 25 yards over the punter's head. And we said, I think we found our punter. And he punted as a JV guy, as a freshman, and continued. And now he's a Division I guy making an impact for the Illini on special teams.
That is fantastic coaching as Imani Cross takes it back to the line of scrimmage. Jonathan Brown into double figures now in tackles for Illinois.
Second down and nine from the 4-yard line.
So second and nine, they say, for Nebraska. Tommy Armstrong Jr. got the start, his second consecutive start for the freshman signal caller. And he's played the majority of the game with the exception of one series at quarterback. Here comes the blitz. And look who's there. It's Jonathan Brown to knife his way into the backfield and stop Imani Cross. 11 tackles already for Jonathan Brown, the senior from Memphis, Tennessee.
Well, he's a good-looking linebacker. Everything you like about an instinctive linebacker. He anticipates the snap count. He gets by two would-be blocks and finds his way to the ball carrier. And he turns his shoulders, which is great. He's not always taking blocks on square. So he's making himself small, fitting himself in the holes, and being able to be productive for the Illini. Now they have two timeouts remaining, Tom, with this clock ticking down inside of 2 minutes. So they're hoping to get excellent field position if they can get off the field here on third down.
And they'll have the wind at their back. Cross trying to stretch it out. He's in the end zone and taken down. Officially ruled a safety. Mason Monheim was the first one there. Houston Bates able to clean it up. And what a huge play for the Illini defense. Getting points from the defense and the ball coming back to him. Where was the forward progress?
Ruling on the field is that the runner broke free from the initial hit, went back in the end zone on his own, tackled, safety.
Boy, as a running back, you definitely have to know where you are on the football field. And Imani Cross, he gets his football and he's going to the outside. He needs to go north and south, get what you can, and don't make a bad play worse. Terrific job by Monheim going in and getting the initial tackle. He breaks free. Now he's in the end zone. And good rally to the football by the white shirts there from the Illini.
And the key you heard from Bill LaMagne, our white hat today, was that Cross went into the end zone on his own, even though you would see the forward progress had him all the way out to nearly the 3-yard line when that run started. So Monheim with a huge stop for Illinois. After this free kick, they'll get the ball with the wind at their back and 2 timeouts remaining.
Well, if you're the Illini on special teams, you want to think about fielding this football cleanly. It's going to be knocked down by the wind, so you have to be able to play the football cleanly, and you should have excellent field position with still 2 timeouts remaining and a minute 44 before halftime.
So Mauro Bondi will kick it away.
I'll go get the ball. Help me out, man.
Bentley should have a chance for a return. He's been quiet today. It's a good kick into the wind. Taken by Osei. Osei finds some room on the left side. And this big return carries it all the way out past the 45. Harvey Jackson saved a touchdown for Nebraska. Now Shieldhouse will have an opportunity.
It's a nice decision just to get what you can to the short side of the field. And now, as you said, Tom, Illini offense is going to set up close to the 50-yard line. Plenty of time on the clock for a veteran quarterback in Nathan Shieldhouse to get more points.
See if they trick it up a little bit. Here comes the blitz. Open field tackle on Martez Barr made by Andrew Green. Complete. Nearly to the line of scrimmage to Ferguson. David Santos with the coverage.
And I think this sellout crowd is complaining that the offensive line for the Illini may be getting a little holding calls or getting away with some of the holding calls on that interior offensive line.
3rd and 7. Tough snap. Here's the blitz. Shieldhouse incomplete. Barr couldn't get his hands underneath it. Corey Cooper, the nearest defender.
Boy, you have to make that play if you're Barr on the outside. Shieldhouse does a nice job of buying a couple extra of yards in the pocket. Really couldn't step up because of the pressure. Ball was low, but you have to be able to make this play. Try to come back to the football. All you do is cradle it, and you have enough yards for the first down.
So Duvernoy back on to punt again. That's Westerkamp. He'll let it go. And this ball will be down just outside the goal line. Great stop by Illinois special teams. Duvernoy able to kill it inside the one. Justin Hardy down there. How about Nebraska's D today?
Well, they've been able to do it all. They've been able to set the tone by turning the football over as the Illini were driving to start this football game. The Blackshirts come up with a big play and then big hits from this secondary. They've been sticking like plaster in the secondary, and they've been plastering the quarterback, Nathan Shieldhouse, with the pressure they've been able to provide on third down.
John Papuchis worked with Bo Pelini at LSU. He said they prepared for Illinois as Nebraska's trying to get it out of the end zone by going back and watching some old Arkansas tape back with Peyton Hillis and Darren McFadden. Timeout used by Illinois with 44 seconds left. Papuchis was originally with Will Muschamp at LSU. Pelini came in a year later. But they said that Illinois is so difficult to prepare for that we had to go deep into the video vaults to find offenses similar that we faced as a staff. And the numbers impressive today when you see what they've done against the pass game. But to be fair, Illinois was going into a 25-mile-an-hour win for a quarter.
And this is an offense, though, in Illinois, Tom, that has been able to put points on the scoreboard. They're averaging over 40 points a game. They have a quarterback that's been able to almost outdo what he did through the air through four games in an entire season in 10 games that he played last year. So this is an offense that's been productive. So let's credit Nebraska and the adjustments that Bo Pelini and Papuchis has made on the defensive side. They've made adjustments with young players, and so far through two quarters, they've done a great job.
Nebraska trying to work its way out of the north end zone, and this will be Abdullah. And that'll bring up third down. Illinois will use another timeout. They are really anxious to take advantage of this win and get another opportunity before the half comes to an end. Big game in the Big Ten tonight as the Buckeyes look to stretch the nation's longest winning streak to 18 on ABC Saturday Night Football when they face a formidable road test against the undefeated Wildcats. Saturday Night Football presented by Windows as part of Tailgate Week, fired up by Kings for Charcoal. Number 4 Ohio State versus 16th ranked Northwestern tonight at 8 Eastern, 5 Pacific on ABC. That's just one of the big top 10 matchups today. Clemson is in the Carrier Dome for the first time against Syracuse. LSU will head to Stark Vegas to take on Mississippi State later tonight on ESPN. And don't forget about the nightcap. Should be a fun one in Palo Alto. Washington and Stanford go head-to-head at 10:30 Eastern. Nebraska takes a knee, and Illinois out of timeouts will not have an opportunity to get the ball back. Bo Pelini's defense coming up with stops when they need it today. And Nebraska will hit the locker room with a 23-5 advantage over Illinois. So as the Huskers walk the red carpet, they can do so at ease as the first half comes to a close here in Lincoln with Nebraska in the lead in this Big Ten opener. Now to SportsCenter U with Dari Noka and Kevin Carter. Today in Lincoln, it's the Huskers' 103rd homecoming, and I don't know in all those years if they've had a more prominent grand marshal in the homecoming parade than young Jack Hoffman. The Huskers up 23-5. You remember the spring game back in April when Hoffman, then a 7-year-old battling pediatric brain cancer, took this snap. And he had a convoy to help him. A 69-yard touchdown run with the rest of the Nebraska team. And 80. The best news for this young grand marshal is that his cancer is currently in remission, according to his father. And he appeared yesterday as the grand marshal, Jack Hoffman, the grand marshal of Nebraska's homecoming parade as they celebrate their 103rd homecoming in Lincoln.
Just an awesome story, Tom, and I'm sure that the team and head coach Bo Pelini, you know, really love that moment, because that's a thing that can bring everybody together. And it's great to hear Jack, who's had a birthday since that historic touchdown he had in the spring game, is now 8 years old and you know, on to bigger and better things and in remission. So it's a nice story, and hopefully his improved health continues.
John, you Youngstown guys have a reputation for being tough guys in a tough town, but Bo Pelini is one of those guys behind closed doors. He's really a softy.
He's a great man. He's a great family man. He's a great father. He has three children, and He's one of those guys that I think his teammates, his teammates from high school, his teammates from college, his team now knows the person that he is. And it just one of those guys you want to root for to do well because he deserves it. And he has done well. This is a good stretch for this football team to come out and play well in the first half, try to take care of business in the second half, move on to the next week. Then they get a bye, and the bulk of their Big Ten schedule is ahead of them. But first things first, they have to come out and play with the attention to detail they had in the first half, offensively, defensively, and it starts here with special teams.
It's been a stressful couple of weeks for those in and around the Nebraska program, and that includes this entire state of 1.8 million. No chance for a return for Amir Abdullah. We saw two different quarterbacks in the first half for Nebraska, led by Tommy Armstrong Jr. He was relieved by Ron Kellogg, the third, for one series. Both guys seeing action after Taylor Martinez suffered a turf toe injury earlier this season. It's on his second and third toes of his left foot, suffered it against Wyoming, and it severely limited Martinez's run game. In fact, looking at about 20 yards in the two games against Southern Miss and UCLA. And if Martinez can't run, that makes him one-dimensional. And so he will not see action today. This is Abdullah. And Abdullah stretches it out for a good gain on first down. Ernest Thomas III with the tackle for Illinois.
Tom, the one thing I've noticed in Nebraska's running game, if you're a running back, you have to have patience to be able to stretch that play to the outside and know when to cut it north and south. And Abdullah and Cross, and for a couple plays, Newby, who's now in the football game, has been able to do that.
I don't know that we've seen Amani Cross back on the field since he ran back into the end zone and suffered a safety. Terrell Newby just replaced him moments ago. Cross came on the field, but he was called back. Deep ball. And it is fought for and incomplete, but a flag on the play. Anunua covered by Bentley. Quincy Anunua has extended his receiving streak to 19 games today.
Pass interference, defense number two, 15-yard penalty, automatic, first down.
Bentley was challenging on the outside. Good tight coverage. He's running. He's on the inside hip. That may have been a hands to the face by Anunua early, but there's the arm, the right arm, and you have to be able to turn and locate the football a little bit sooner if you're Bentley.
This is Abdullah once again showing that patience, and he's able to take it with a somersault down to nearly the 44-yard line. Tim Kennard, senior from Toledo, Ohio, with the tackle for Illinois.
Well, I'm so impressed with the balance shown by Amir Abdullah. He's able to stretch those running plays to the outside, then put one foot in the ground and take it north and south. But you have to have great vision and terrific balance to be able to do that.
Armstrong now out of the pistol. Abdullah has a lot of room on the left side and great blocking out there, but there's a flag on the play. Anunua was blocking on the edge, and that flag came back towards the offensive line. Multiple flags. In fact, one of the officials had to throw his hat down near the 40.
Not so sure those offensive linemen were out of the tackle box where they were on the legs of the Illini defenders.
On the play, one live ball, one dead ball. Personal foul. Illegal low block. Offense. Dead ball. Personal foul. Number nine, defense. That personal foul will result in an automatic first down.
Head linesman Michael Dolce threw his flag and threw his hat.
he didn't have much else to draw, but you can take a look here. Searles is going to go ahead and take a chop block here on Monheim, and as well as Long, he may get the call as well on the outside, but both of these guys kind of throw at the legs of the backers. That's one of the calls, and then the personal foul outside. Just not a good decision by Thomas on the edge. Yes, you want to make the play, but just ride guys out of bounds. I don't understand why you need to hit somebody when they're giving themselves up to the boundary.
Well, Nebraska's going backwards after the penalty, but it's really not all that bad because they pick up the first down. That's some easy math when you go back 15 and then forward 15.
I got that
nothing.
One. Yeah, I got that one, T.
Should be a first down, but they don't show it on the markers just yet on the far side. And now corrected. So, Nebraska back to the option. Abdullah has been wearing out the Illinois edge, and this time, what a beautiful cutback! He's going to take it all the way! Amir Abdullah in! After taking the option pitch for 43 yards.
Tom, that's a thing of beauty. Anytime you can get Amir Abdullah on the outside and get him some room to run, he's going to make one cut that's going to make two or three people miss. That time he does it for 43 and 6 points.
That move against the grain at the 30 was the difference maker, and the extra point is good this time for Marl Bondi, who's taken over the PAT duties for Nebraska after Smith mixed one. Good old option football for Nebraska, and fantastic vision for Amir Abdullah. You're watching ESPNU College Football, presented by Polaris. It's a 30-5 lead for Nebraska. Illinois' offense has produced only a field goal today.
That's been the main story of this football game right there. Running back Amir Abdullah, his fourth 100-yard rushing game this season. I think the other game he was in the 90s, but 13 rushes for 141 yards. Terrific average in the two touchdowns.
He's touched the ball 14 times today, including a reception, and he's averaging 11.1 yards a touch. Angled kick will be a touchback. And let's look at the touchdown. The cutback came at the 30. This play designed much earlier than that.
Great design, Bo, but watch the triangle here and what they do. Everybody's eyes are on the quarterback, and no one gets outside leverage on Abdullah. You're going to be able to freeze it right there. Now you've got a hook here. You've got a block downfield, a block here, and a block here that's going to allow your running back to get to the outside. That's just a good design by getting outside leverage with your blocking and then continuing to block downfield. You see linemen, you see wide receivers continuing to run with Abdullah in the end zone. That's a team win for Nebraska.
Now Illinois shows the option. Shieldhouse keeps it and cuts back, and he finds a yard and a half. Nebraska has found the success on the perimeter today when it comes to the ground game.
Abdullah has been able to do it on the outside, and especially to his right side. That's where he has 5 for 78 yards in the one touchdown. T, Tom, you mentioned it. He only touched the football 13 times on the ground, but he has 141 yards and those two scores. So it's been outside leverage and Nebraska getting a hat on hat with the receivers down the field to provide running room for Abdullah.
There's plenty of time for this Illinois offense to put some points on the board. They came into this game averaging better than 40 points a game. Play clock at 3. This is Donovan Young, and he has a first down, and a spin move will net him a few more yards to the 40 before Andrew Green takes him to the turf. You think with this weather that if Illinois is going to make a dent in the deficit, it's going to have to come in the third quarter with the wind at their back.
It has to, because in the fourth quarter, with the score the way it is, it's going to be four down territory just about anywhere when you cross the 50-yard line. So right now, the veteran quarterback, Nathan Schilhaus, has to start engineering a touchdown drive right now.
Again, Young may have been a hold, no flag, and a good tackle made by Jason Ankra, who was able to fight off that block and bring his man down.
Nebraska forced a U-turn run that time. He started one way and he had to throw it in reverse and go all the way across the field. When you can get Donovan Young and Josh Ferguson to do that, it's a win for the Blackshirts.
Josh Ferguson now in at running back. Schilhaus will roll. He's got a day and a half. Now he goes to his tight end, Davis, out of the backfield, and he takes it past midfield. And Illinois first down, Cooper with the stop. John. Nebraska's defense in the first half was able to come up with big stops to shut down lengthy Illinois drives.
Well, you're right, Tom. It wasn't that the Illini offensively wasn't moving the football. They just couldn't get it into the end zone. They had the fumble early in the football game, and then the Nebraska defense would stiffen up inside the red zone.
Nathan Gary is on the field now for the Huskers at linebacker in this nickel look. And they're going to run it against the nickel. And Ferguson surges forward to find a few here on first down. Nearly five on first down.
Really impressed with the running backs today. Donovan Young and Josh Ferguson. You throw in Amir Abdullah. You've got three talented running backs in this conference that are going to provide big plays for their teams as the season moves on.
Cut back by Ferguson. And he finds the sideline and gets tripped up. An open field, perhaps touchdown saving tackle made by Corey Cooper.
Kind of an odd pitch and a counter back to the wide side. And Nebraska does everything correctly. Ankara's there for the tackle for a loss. They just lose the edge. You lose leverage on the outside against a guy that has speed in Ferguson. That's going to move the chains offensively for Illinois.
Illinois running backs Young and Ferguson have combined for 127 yards on 20 carries. Ferguson against the blitz takes it to the 30, a gain of 4. Randy Gregory, who was injured in the second quarter, in on the stop with Thad Randall. ESPNU's college football continues later today at 3:30. Paul Johnson's Yellow Jackets head to the beach to take on 14th ranked Miami. Then at 7, a pair of 3-1 teams, 24th ranked Ole Miss and Auburn, go head-to-head in the SEC. ESPNU's college football, 3:30 and 7 on ESPNU. Both games also live on Watch ESPN. Donovan Young. And that will set up 3rd and 2, Cooper with the tackle. Young and Ferguson able to churn out some yards here for Illinois in the ground game.
They've been able to do a nice job coming out after halftime. They've got a nice drive going, but now it's and a long two for the Illini.
And they're going to mix it up. Aaron Bailey enters the game at quarterback. There's some miscommunication for the Illini. Bailey, a Wildcat quarterback. This is what Nebraska prepared for by watching old Arkansas tape. Takes a snap. He's going to keep it, and he's got nowhere to go. Avery Moss covers up Aaron Bailey.
Tom, sometimes you can outwit or outsmart yourself, and I'm sure that offensive coordinator Bill Cubitt would like to have that play over because there was miscommunication in the way they wanted to set up. There was no surprise for the defense of Nebraska, and that allowed Avery Moss just to leap over a would-be blocker and get the tackle for loss.
Four down territory for the Illini. Shieldhouse is back in at quarterback. Fourth and five. Complete for the first down to Ferguson, and the Illini drive stays alive. I like what you said about kind of outthinking yourself. You're moving the ball with your running backs. You try to get tricky.
You've got rhythm, and you want to have the guy pulling the trigger that you want pulling the trigger, and that's Nathan Shieldhouse. Keep him in the football game on third down so you don't have to convert on fourth. And that's not the first time that the Illini have run that under route, that the crossing route where you almost get a natural pick for the running back, Josh Ferguson. That was a nice job by Ryan Langford, kind of rubbing for Josh Ferguson to get open.
Andrew Green is the injured Husker on the field, senior from San Antonio's Madison High School. He's had a busy day at safety, replacing Harvey Jackson there. And Green will be helped to the sideline. He was getting blocked at the end of this play by Martez Barr and got his right knee rolled up on it, looked like.
Let's hope he's okay, because he's made the switch from corner now to safety, and he had the big hit in the first half over the middle. One of those guys that are not afraid to come up and strike you from the secondary.
Seems like the wind has picked up here in the second half coming out of the south end zone. The backs, this Illinois offense. Midway through the third quarter. Blitz coming. Shieldhouse stands tall and completes it to Evan Wilson. Incomplete. They say it was off the turf on a sliding attempt by Wilson.
Pressure that time on first down by the Cornhuskers defensively. Kind of get the quarterback retreating. Never had a chance to really set his feet and step and throw.
Twelfth play of the drive for Shieldhouse in Illinois. Ferguson and Davis join him in the backfield. Ferguson wrapped up behind the line. Randy Gregory with the stop. It will be a gain of one. And that sets up third and nine. The junior college transfer having an impact for the Huskers.
Tom, this is an example of using your eyes and then shedding a blocker to get behind the line of scrimmage and making a play. Watch the way Gregory gets to the line, sheds the would-be block or the fake from John Davis, the tight end, and then gets to the ball carrier. That's the next level where these young players need to be for Bo Pelini's defense.
Davis has to put a hat on him, doesn't he?
Sure does. He didn't get there in time.
On third and nine, Shieldhouse has Davis trying to atone for that mistake. He's got a first down as he dives out of bounds, chased by Santos. And he'll be marked at the 1 yard line, a pickup of 14.
John Davis, he may not be much of a blocker, but he catches the football and he knows what to do with it after in run after catch situations. That ball's to his back shoulder. He did a great job of just idling down to catch the football and then get inside the 5 yard line.
Quickly to the ball once again. Stack dive formation for Illinois. Quick snap. And straight ahead, Young He is in. Touchdown, Illinois. Their first touchdown of the day on a Donovan Young plunge. Now, Illinois will get tricky with their PAT attempts. And we have to keep an eye on what they'll do with long snapper Tim Russell at times.
There was no trickeration there on the one-yard run.
And here's what we're talking about. Swinging gate formation, they'll spread out their tackles. And the holder, Russell, is in position to take the snap, and now he takes a knee and they go conventional. They've converted two-point conversions on PATs this season. Zaleski has made one field goal today. And that is the 154th consecutive PAT made by an Illinois kicker dating back to 2009 against Missouri. Illinois gets the touchdown, but it comes at the expense of a lot of time off the clock.
ESPNU College Football, brought to you by Zaxby's, the official chicken of college fans, and Miracle-Gro. Enter to win a trip to the Rose Bowl. For details, visit miraclegrow.com/Rose Bowl.
Illinois with his first touchdown of the game, trailing 30-12. They also have a field goal and a safety to their credit today. That scoring drive ends up with the touchdown, but it costs them 7 minutes and 4 seconds. That's the longest scoring drive of the season.
PAT is good.
I think Nebraska had 12 guys on the field, Tom, on that extra point opportunity. Illinois obviously declines it, so they'll kick off now. But you, to your point, that scoring drive, you get the points, but you take so much time off the clock, you're going to have to rely on your special teams or your defense to try to get the football back so you don't have to go 70, 75, 80 yards. You can't afford to do that with 5:54 left to go in the third quarter.
Abdullah, watch it sail over his head. 30-12 here. Let's check in once again with Dari.
Tom, this Liv Moss moment brought to you by Taco Bell. Indiana has never beaten Penn State in 16 tries. Tevin Coleman busts one for the Hoosiers. 44 yards. They go for two and get it. 21-14 Indiana midway through the third.
Wow, what a huge victory that would be for Kevin Wilson's Hoosiers. And his former team, Northwestern, has a huge one tonight at home against Ohio State. Ron Kellogg has taken over at quarterback for Nebraska. A little naked bootleg, and with gloves on, he throws complete to Kenny Bell, out of bounds at the 31-yard line. Ron Kellogg is an Omaha kid. He's from Westside High School. His dad, Ron Kellogg Jr., was a prep superstar as a high school basketball player. He ended up playing for Larry Brown at Kansas and helping the Jayhawks to the Final Four, a team with Danny Manning as a freshman that would eventually win the 1988 national title. Abdullah with the carry.
I've been impressed with both of these quarterbacks. You have the redshirt freshman Armstrong, who's come out and done a nice job, but Kellogg, he just gives you that calm presence you need at a quarterback spot. I think Armstrong has the juice, Kellogg has the savvy, and it's a nice blend between youth and experience.
Kellogg hands it off to Newby. And Newby lost the football going out of bounds as Ernest Thomas shoved him to the Illinois sideline. Matchup today between the two Nebraska quarterbacks, Armstrong and Kellogg.
Very efficient. Kellogg hasn't played as much as Armstrong, but he's only missed on one attempt, and Armstrong's been able to get this team into the end zone. He's done a nice job of organizing everybody, getting to the line of scrimmage, and making nice decisions in the run and the pass game.
Kellogg wants to throw, and that is incomplete. Skipped it to Westerkamp. Kellogg's dad was known as Mr. Saturday at Kansas for what he was able to do for Larry Brown's Jayhawks. Ron Kellogg III, though, could be considered Mr. Everyday, the way he works with this Nebraska team as a coach on the sideline. In fact, on Saturdays before he found playing time, he was Tim Beck's tempo coach, reminding the offensive coordinator when they could go with the various tempos, sonic, indy, jet, speed, to try to get the offense going. Pressured on third and 10. Now time. And incomplete. Anunua, the intended receiver. And that'll bring it into that series from Ron Kellogg.
Good job by the Illini in the secondary. They had everybody covered down the field. Kellogg had plenty of time to load and then reload, trying to find a receiver. But that was an excellent job by Tim Beckman. That defense sticking to everybody in a red jersey.
Have we seen Sam Fultz today for Nebraska?
I don't believe so. Saw him in warm-up.
First punt of the day for the Huskers. Bentley to return. Fair catch asked for, and he takes it at the 23. There's a flag on the play as Kenny Bell was racing down the field to try and make a play from his gunner position. The fans here at Memorial Stadium are so dialed in, you can hear their groans before you see the flag come out.
They saw Darius Mosley.
There's no foul on the play. When a fair catch is made, the blocking question is deemed legal.
Bill Lamagne knows how to quiet 90,000. Pick up the flag and wave it off. 4:37 to go in the third quarter from Memorial Stadium. Fair catch by Bentley, fair block by Illinois.
You're watching Tailgate Week, fired up by Kingsford Charcoal.
What a scene here in downtown Lincoln, Nebraska. A little breakfast burrito action. Get that close to the grill, you've got to be properly lubricated.
Those guys are professionals.
Big red, big food, big spreads. Five wide receivers for Nathan Shieldhouse. And Martez Barr turned the Nebraska defender around with a simple catch, and that got him a first down.
I don't believe Jonathan Rose, the corner, ever saw the football thrown to the short side of the field. Barr just took it and said, thank you very much. I'll go down the Illinois sideline, and it looks like Shieldhouse back ready to go again with this tempo.
They were going no huddle in that situation. The defense has a chance to answer substitutions with their own, and that's why the umpire was standing over the football. Bo Pelini communicating with his defensive coordinator, John Papuchis, as they work the defense hand in hand. Illinois in that situation ran off one player, wide receiver Spencer Harris, and that one man should have been enough for Nebraska to get as many subs in as they wanted. But for whatever reason, the Huskers still decided to use a timeout.
And Tom, that wind is really starting to pick up again like it was in the pregame, and it's at the back of the Illini offense. So you want to, if you're the Illini right now, you have to score more points with 4 minutes and 29 seconds left to go in this third quarter, because when you turn the other way, it's going to be very difficult not only to locate the football, but your kicking game, you're really in four down territory.
Nebraska relieved to have a 30-12 edge with that wind gusting. This is Ferguson, and Ferguson with the bounce and another first down. Corey Cooper. And the Nebraska defensive backs have been busy running guys out of bounds.
And the sophomore out of Naperville, Illinois, is talented. He can dip inside and bounce it outside, and he doesn't lose a step.
Extra tackle on the left side for Illinois, multiple tight ends. And that does nothing. In fact, it's a loss of one for Donovan Young. It's a Big Ten opener for 3-1 Nebraska and 3-1 Illinois. And that's a little bit of confusion for that young man, but he will come out a winner regardless of the outcome today. Cornhuskers with the lead, 30-12. Tom Hart alongside John Congemi, happy to have you here today. Second and 11. Here comes the blitz. Shieldhouse facing pressure, incomplete, trying to find Barr. And Nathan Shieldhouse has just been off a little bit when that pressure has come to his face.
And that's the second time he's tried to find Barr on the outside while he was retreating. Watch the feet of the quarterback. You have to be able to give ground to buy yourself some time from Thad Randall, and he just misses Barr on a big play opportunity to the outside. Now you have third and long, where you would have moved the chains had you been just a little bit more accurate with the football.
Corner blitz coming. Shieldhouse didn't see it, and it's picked off. Intercepted by Ankra. That was made possible by Siante Evans coming from his cornerback spot. And it's another Nebraska takeaway.
Tom, third down means pressure for Nebraska on defense. And Evans is going to come from the top of your screen. That's your guy. If you're the quarterback, if you're a Steelhouse, you have to be able to know, I've got to get rid of the football before that corner gets to me. He's my guy. Just the leap at the end of that play by Evans tips the football to one of his teammates. Now Nebraska tees it up with excellent field position.
It's a second interception by a Nebraska defensive lineman this season. This is Abdullah. And Abdullah picks up a couple of yards on the left side. Tommy Armstrong is back at quarterback for the Huskers.
Now Nebraska trying to go a little bit more up-tempo offensively.
Armstrong wants the deep ball, and it's incomplete. Kenny Bell started his route and then stopped. Third and 8.
Everyone not on the same page on the outside. It looked like Bell ran a stop route to the outside. His redshirt freshman quarterback thought he was on the go route. So now they have to convert third and long. They've been able to attack the middle of the football field when they've gone one back and four wide, crossing routes.
No crossing routes here. Inside, one-handed grab by Kenny Bell, and he's in. Sports Center top 10 on the score for Bell. It goes for 37 yards.
Are you kidding me? That's it. That may be number one.
There's a flag on the play down at the 3-yard line. Here's Bill Lamonier.
Touchdown is good. Following the touchdown, that ball, that's personal conduct, number 80. That 15-yard penalty, beyond the kickoff.
Don't forget the new rule last year. If Kenny Bell would have drawn that flag before he crossed the goal line, they would have taken the points away. And that would be hashtag not top 10.
This is unbelievable. This catch, one-handed grab. He just goes up and snags it in between four defenders. And Bell gets into the end zone, a 37-yarder from Armstrong to Bell.
It was very Irving Fryer of him. Bondion for the extra point. And he missed it. Best hair in the Big Ten belongs to Kenny Bell. And maybe the best catch of this Saturday belongs to Kenny Bell.
What an effort to go up and snag this with his right hand in between four defenders and get into the end zone. 37-yarder, that's just Velcro. Go up and get it, young man.
And that's where the flag came after Kenny Bell shushed his own crowd. That's tough to do with 90,000.
You're not going to do that here in Lincoln, I can tell you that.
Bell had a couple of plays against South Dakota State that he deemed to be drops. He also had a fumble, and he took that game hard. No drop there. For the junior from Boulder, Colorado.
He has every reason to keep that smile on his face. That was a sensational grab.
Osei and Bentley stand at their own 16. And Bentley passed the 40. Jason Ankra with the special team stop. How good is this catch?
Tom, I think you said it best. He may have the best hair in the Big Ten, but that may be the best catch you've seen this year. I mean, he's going to go elevate in the middle of the field around four white jerseys in that Illinois defense, and nobody can make a play on the football. Terrific concentration just to take it down and then have the wherewithal to get into the end zone. That's number one in my book.
Shieldhouse lets it go over the middle, complete. Matt Lacoste with his first grab of the day. And a first down for Illinois. Green with the tackle, 21-yard gain. That young man likes number 80.
He's a smart young man. He picked the right jersey today.
Ferguson with a little bit of lean picks up 2 yards off of Lava with the stop for Nebraska.
Let's credit a little bit on the defensive side for Nebraska. This is an offense in Illinois that came in averaging 40 points a game, almost 480 yards in total offense per game. This defense has come up with some big plays today, forcing turnovers and getting off the field on third down.
Ferguson and Davis into the backfield. Shieldhouse under center. And Ferguson on the cutback takes it down to the 31. Michael Rose with the stop. Rose, like Shieldhouse, the Illinois quarterback, attended high school just a few hours south of here in Kansas City at perennial power Rockhurst High. A couple of Hawklets going head-to-head today. Third and four with a minute to go in the third quarter.
Looks like Nebraska's going to play coverage this time. Normally they've been bringing pressure on third down.
They bring a linebacker, and Shieldhouse lets it go behind the receiver, incomplete. His man was Barr. Andrew Green, number 11 on the coverage for Nebraska.
Definitely four down territory for this offense now, and Nathan Shieldhouse, he's the guy that needs to move the chains here on fourth down.
They've converted one today.
Now comes the pressure on fourth down.
Here comes Evans and company. They bring the house, Shieldhouse off his back foot, and it's incomplete. Once again, trying to find Barr on the out route against the pressure. He was covered by Rose. And Illinois turns it over on downs.
And Tom, sometimes you have to shorten your route on fourth down when you know they're bringing the house and it's zero coverage. Barr may have to shorten that route so he can make it quarterback friendly for the conversion.
Undefeated Pac-12 North rivals square off tonight on ESPN as the number 15 Huskies look to upset the fifth-ranked Cardinal on the road. Both teams are rolling. It's a huge matchup with conference and BCS implications. Tailgate week, fired up by Kings for Charcoal. Washington versus Stanford tonight at 10:30 on ESPN. Also live on Watch ESPN. This is Abdullah. This is Abdullah going past midfield. And Amir Abdullah finally brought down by Ernest Thomas III. 33 yards on the run by Abdullah. That is his third carry today of 30 yards or longer.
Amir has had some terrific plays on the ground and receiving the football, but I like him best when he's in space in the open field. He makes so many people miss at the point of attack. A career-high day with 182 yards on 16 attempts and two touchdowns. You deserve a rest, young man.
Cross in for the first time, I believe, in the second half for Nebraska. And he will bring it into the third quarter with a 3-yard gain. Austin Teitsma with the tackle for the Illini. Nebraska's defense has been good. Hits offense has been great. Led by Amir Abdullah, his 10th 100-yard game in his career. A career day for the Nebraska I-back. Huskers running wild just like they used to do and handling Illinois through three quarters today, 36-12, a career-high 182 for Abdullah. Quarterbacks have been efficient. And Nebraska's defense with a pair of big takeaways today. You know, I'm with an old quarterback here in the booth, and the first thing he noticed when watching Nebraska game film was the footballs. These are not bright, shiny, fresh out of the bag or box pigskins. These have been roughed up. They've been beat up a little bit. They're even losing some paint on the stripes. And that is to the Huskers' design. And this is to their design as well. Amir Abdullah is running wild today, and he's down the sideline for a first down. Why do they like old footballs here in Lincoln?
Well, I don't know why they do, but I know the advantage of using it, and that's to the quarterback's advantage and to the guys that handle the football. It's just so much easier to grab. It's just so much easier to handle, especially on a day like today where it's raw outside. The wind's blowing. A new ball would be slick to throw, to kick. That ball right there, you can throw in any weather, and it doesn't matter what the conditions are.
Broken play. Armstrong gets swallowed up in a loss of five. Cross and Armstrong couldn't decide. So there's a look at the bag.
I mean, you couldn't go out and find balls like that. I might not even use one of those on the street.
And they look like they have been used on the street.
Yeah, you know, go out and rough them up. I'm sure Coach Pelini has his kids go rough those things up in the yard and on the street and then bring them back for practice.
All balls are approved by the officials for use in the game before the game by the officiating crew. Armstrong let's one go to the end zone, and it's batted away, and a big-time play by Eaton Spence. Zimmer, the fullback, was the intended receiver. You actually, when you were at the quarterback at Pitt, you had a night spent in the hotel just trying to rough some up.
Just trying to get those eggs exactly the way you want them, and sometimes when you get them out of the bags and you have to use them on game day, they're very slick. Now, I'm sure that they've improved the way they make footballs today, but those are not brand new. Those have been probably a month and a half on the practice field, and they're much easier to handle.
I believe those were in play when the fumble Ruski was still legal.
It very well could have been. But they know what to do with them today. 36 points on the scoreboard, and the quarterbacks and everybody handling the football has done it with efficiency.
Old school, what a move on a fake on the pitch for a big gain by Tommy Armstrong, pulling a Tommy Frazier, who's going into the College Football Hall of Fame. T.J. Neal with the stop, and this is what have Nebraska faithful so excited about his future.
Well, they should be. I mean, you mentioned a great quarterback in Nebraska lore in Tommy Frazier. This guy has a bright future ahead of him in Tommy Armstrong. He can run it, he can throw it, but most importantly, he makes terrific decisions from the pocket.
It's undecided when Taylor Martinez will return from his turf toe. They have Purdue next week, then a bye week. They could keep him out and get him healthy. They might have a decision to make at QB. Fourth and two to go for it. Armstrong to
He's
throw.
Got him.
He's got a man. Just off the hands of Trey Foster. Would have been the first catch for the redshirt freshman from Lincoln Southeast High School. Nebraska decided to go for it on fourth down. And that kickball out of Armstrong's hands just floated a little bit too far. You gotta go higher. You gotta go
higher. Dari Noke in studio. Don't forget, coming up about 40 minutes from now, Duke Johnson in Miami. Duke's got at least one touchdown in his last eight games. Miami, Georgia Tech. Guys, it's a big game in the Coastal Division.
Dari, thanks. I assume they'll have better weather on South Beach than we're experiencing here in Lincoln. Taylor Martinez has the hoodie on, trying to come back from a turf issue. Second and third toe of his left foot, and he hasn't been himself since the Wyoming game. School record of touchdowns and total offense last season. He holds 37 different Nebraska records. Streak closed for the second consecutive week. Tough spot for Illinois. Down big here in the fourth quarter. Coming out after the defensive stop. And past the five goes Josh Ferguson.
Tom, getting back a little bit to the starting quarterback, Taylor Martinez, I would think they would rest him all the way through the bye week. The way that Tommy Armstrong and Ron Kellogg can play and put up and move this football team, putting up points, why not? Why rush him back? You've got the bulk of your Big Ten season after the next bye. I'd let him rest and see how he feels in a couple weeks.
Second and seven. Nice move through traffic before Michael Rose had the stop on Ferguson. They draw a Purdue team next week that is just 1-4 on the season and really struggling.
And this defense is going to continue to improve. They've got a lot of youth. We talked about it at the open. We talked about it through the duration of this football game. They're going to improve drastically on defense. They have to. They must improve if they're going to compete for a Big Ten title.
Shieldhouse trying to find Ferguson, and it's over his arm. And now Justin Duvernoy will come on to punt it away for Illinois. You know, you tried to make Duvernoy a wide receiver as a youngster when he was a freshman in high school. You said then that he didn't have the hands. He better have hands here, punting from his own end zone.
And don't take for granted, you know, catching this football is easy today with this wind whipping around.
Westerkamp stands on the logo. Nebraska will have positive field position with 11:50 remaining in this one from Memorial Stadium in Lincoln.
ESPNU College Football is presented by Polaris. See the most complete lineup of off-road vehicles at Polaris.com.
You know, the League of American Bicyclists have recognized the University of Nebraska as a bike-friendly university. They have a free bike valet program where fans can secure their bikes near the stadium and then claim them after the game to avoid traffic congestion and television announcers who are in a hurry to get to the airport.
I know I'm going for an upgrade if I'm going to one of those bikes.
I mean,
that's
yeah,
for sure.
What if you turn in a Huffy and you leave with something
speed.
Nicer? Yeah,
that's right. Give me a mountain bike.
Here's Amani Cross trying to do his best to Amir Abdullah, and he takes it down to the 34-yard line. In all honesty, they do so many great things here at the University of Nebraska on game day. There's really no place like it, just statistically speaking, 330 consecutive sellouts, which is an NCAA record. And tough to imagine that one ever being matched. Cross takes it straight ahead. And of those Nebraska faithful, no matter what they thought of Bo Pelini a couple of weeks ago, you have to feel a lot better about this program, especially going into the Purdue game after a performance like this today.
Well, you put 36 up on the board and you still have over 11 minutes left to go. I would think the Nebraska faithful has to feel pretty good about what they've seen so far out of Bo Pelini's football team. They've shown toughness. They've shown the ability to use two quarterbacks when their starter's out with turf toe. And this defense, the youth on this defense is starting to grow up a little bit.
This is Cross again. And he lost the football. Second mistake for Cross today, who ran into the end zone for a safety. And now he coughs it up, and we'll see who wins the wrestling match at the bottom. Officials say Illinois football.
And just when Amani Cross thought he was out of the doghouse, they're going to bring him back in. It's one thing you cannot do as a running back and cough up the football twice. Once he backed up into his own end zone, causing a safety, but there's the hit right on the football. Not much you can do there, but in a situation where you're up 36-12, you want to put both hands on that football and secure that thing. That's the most important thing. Not the yards you're picking up, but securing the football.
Mason Monheim popped it loose. Kenny Nelson recovered it. A Nebraska unsettled defensively. Illinois gets a snap off, and it's incomplete. So even when the Illini see an advantage, they're unable to make it pay off today. Huskers only had one down defensive lineman at the time of the snap. There is a flag in the play. Look at the scramble. Actually, they had zero down defensive linemen.
Illegal substitution defense, 12 men. 5-yard penalty, repeat first down.
We're trying to get new bodies into the football game, and I think that Tim Beckman took advantage of getting his offense on the football field. You could call a number of things on this play. You've never seen that defense. That's probably more confusing to Nathan than a regular set defense when they're playing cover three or cover two or some kind of design.
To throw on first and five, incomplete. Barr, the intended receiver. Shieldhouse has just been off his game a little bit today.
And he really only had one game like this, and that was the Washington game, Tom. I believe he was 9 of 25 in that football game earlier in the year.
First career start for Nathan Shieldhouse today. On second and five, this is Young. Rose and Santos combined to bring him down. So third and two for Illinois.
Difficult day to come from behind and locate the football with this wind whipping around Memorial Stadium.
Shieldhouse can't make up his mind which way to go. The pressure came from Randy Gregory, And Shieldhouse has to pick himself off the turf, fourth and two.
Gregory almost had him twice, it seemed like. A lot of red jerseys in the backfield. First guy that was there was Avery Moss. And then you pressure by Moss, runs him right back into Randy Gregory. One of those young players on the edge for Bo Pelini that's growing up in a hurry.
Low line drive. Westerkamp won't have a shot at this one. 41-yard punt for Justin Duvernoy. 9:43 to go in this one from Lincoln. Huskers on a roll.
Visit WatchESPN.com or download the WatchESPN app to watch ESPN live anytime, anywhere. Brought to you by Vizio.
Homecoming crowd on hand today here at Nebraska. Another sellout, 330th consecutive. And if you missed it from earlier, a very special honoree today, the Grand Marshal of the Homecoming Parade, 8-year-old Jack Hoffman, battling pediatric brain cancer, which is currently in remission. Glad to see Jack enjoying the game today. I did the math. Remember Jack had that 69-yard touchdown run in the Nebraska spring game?
Has that been the longest run?
Yeah, I mean, as impressive as Amir Abdullah has been today, his longest was 43. Jack's got him.
Way to go, Jack.
More than 20 yards.
Jack can pick him up and put him down.
Yes, he can. Now, to be fair, he had great blocking that day, and the defensive pursuit left a little to be desired.
He had a lot of white and red jerseys right in front of him. That was still, he was bobbing. He wanted to go left. He bounced it out to the right side. That was a good vision by Jack.
Jack won an ESPY Award for the best moment in sports this summer for his performance in Nebraska's spring game. Play clock running out on Armstrong.
It's number four, 5-yard penalty. Still first down.
Let's assume that Bo Pelini is going to rest Taylor Martinez another game and get him basically 3 weeks for the price of two with that another bye week coming up. And Tommy Armstrong will have a start against Purdue next week. Let's just make that assumption. This is Abdullah.
Wow.
And here he goes again with a fantastic burst to get through that slim hole. He picks up 12. Picks up 17. Petty with the tackle. Will Bo Pelini have a tough decision to make when it comes to quarterback play?
I don't think so. Only because I think you know what you're going to get with Taylor Martinez as the competition grows. But I do believe he'll feel confident about what he has behind him. And at the first sign that things aren't going right or maybe Taylor doesn't feel 100%, he'll have the confidence of knowing that his redshirt freshman quarterback has enough starts and enough playing time under his belt that he'll put him into the football game on the road down by 10. At home, down by 10, or with the lead. He'll have confidence to insert him anywhere in the football game. So I don't think he has a problem. I think he has a luxury on his hands.
That was Amani Cross for six. Every quarterback looks better when your running back is putting together a game like today. Amir Abdullah, 221 yards and a pair of touchdowns. This is Abdullah getting some help from his lineman. He's got a first down, and a juke move gets him a couple more on the outside. Ernest Thomas, the third, with a tackle. Well, Purdue is up next in the bye week, and then here's where Nebraska's season will be decided. To Minnesota on October 26th, and then a gauntlet, divisional games for the most part. Northwestern comes here to the Big House. Home against a defensive-minded Michigan State team at Penn State, at home against Iowa and what is turning into a Big Ten rival. They, you know, it's going to be tough to be perfect the rest of the way. Here's Cross again. And Cross running through tackles. But the fan base here, for the most part, John, even if they expect perfection, they'll take a little bit less than that as long as they're not blown out. And that Big Ten title game against Wisconsin just left a bad feeling in a lot of folks' mouths.
Yeah, the big plays. I think that's been the cause of concern for the Nebraska faithful and the coaching staff, quite frankly. It's been the gashing plays against this defense. And you go back through only four games throughout 2013, you've seen that occur. Now, today they put a stop to it. Today they had some rhythm on defense. They were able to cause turnovers like they have the previous few games. And offensively, they don't seem to be missing a beat now with Tommy Armstrong pulling the trigger.
Option look, bad spacing. So Armstrong hangs a U-turn on Dodge Street. He's inside the 10. And he's able to crawl his way for another couple. Bentley with the stop, and you just saw Tommy Armstrong make something out of nothing.
You're not going to make a living doing this, but this is fun to watch. I'm sure when you're celebrating a victory tomorrow, you can still get some coaching points on this, but this is fun to watch. This is a guy that has high energy. He's a good runner. He's not a great runner. He's a good runner. He can get you enough on the ground and buy you some time to get you inside the 10-yard line.
Here comes the blitz. Abdullah hit in the backfield. Jonathan Brown putting up numbers once again today. Brown had 14 tackles against Cincinnati, at 15 against Washington. He has 13 today.
Three tackles for a loss. This is a guy that just finds the football. He'll have to be at that level this entire season for the Illini to have effectiveness defensively.
Man, they have had some fantastic linebackers in Illinois history, from Ray Nitschke, Dick Butkus, Dana Howard, Kevin Hardy, Simeon Rice, Jay Lehman. Armstrong couldn't get the pitch away with the left hand. Houston Bates was the first man there. Jonathan Brown was also in on that tackle for a loss.
That was a good decision that time by Tommy Armstrong. That pitch had a lot of white jerseys in the path to Amir Abdullah, so he decided just to take the loss and bring his special teams unit on with a 36-12 lead.
14 for Brown, four behind the line of scrimmage, and he will improve his tackle per game average. Pat Smith on for this 32-yard attempt for the Quincy, Illinois native and transfer from Western Illinois. Got it. Nebraska going strong with 5:16 remaining from Lincoln. ESPNU's college football continues later today. It'll be a challenge for Miami hosting Georgia Tech at 3:30. A suspended Chantrell Henderson will not be at right tackle for the Canes today. Then at 7, with both teams at 3-1, the Rebels go on the road to face the Tigers. ESPNU's college football today at 3:30 and 7 on ESPNU. We'll be watching along live on Watch ESPN. John Feliciano has been splitting time with Henderson at right tackle for the Canes, so Al Golden doesn't miss a ton on that offensive line.
That's a good football team in Miami.
Bentley, spurred on by an astronaut, but unable to excite the astronauts today. Amir Abdullah, though, is looking good no matter where you view him, even if you are watching from space.
It looks good from anywhere, inside the stadium or out. He's been able to avoid everyone in a white jersey, and it's been a big play machine. 20 rushes for 225 yards. He has a long of 43. Twice he was able to break the plane of the end zone. His average per carry over 11 yards today. And you can see the numbers between the first half and the second half. We were impressed in the first half, but the second half just throws it over the top.
Riley O'Toole is now in at quarterback for Illinois. Ferguson still in at running back. And he rips off a nice gain on first down. It takes a little something. If you're talking about Abdullah and his 225 yards, it takes a little something to get into Nebraska's top 10 single game rushing records. Roy Helu Jr. went for 307 against Missouri in October of 2010. That's the Nebraska record. This is Ferguson again. I mean, you're trying to match names like Keith Jones, Mike Rozier, I Am Hip, Calvin Jones. It takes 240 yards just to match the 10th spot on Nebraska's all-time single-game rush list.
That's amazing, and what an afternoon for Abdullah. He's able to come up big when his team needed it. You know, starting quarterback on the sidelines with Turf Toe and Taylor Martinez, you get a mixture of Tommy Armstrong and Ron Kellogg, but didn't matter for Amir. He was able to run the football in between the tackles and on the edge with success.
O'Toole will keep this one. And he picks up a few yards needed for the first down. Josh Banderas, the freshman Mike linebacker, who was demoted to second string today, came in on the tackle for the Huskers. It was really interesting talking with the Nebraska coaching staff about the pressures that are on Banderas as a freshman starter. And they said, listen, playing football at Nebraska is living your life in a fishbowl. And they thought at one point that maybe Banderas was getting a little bit overwhelmed with all of the responsibility that comes with being the starting middle linebacker. Incomplete for Ferguson. Banderas started each of the last 3 weeks, but so, you know, here's a guy who's seeing everything for the first time, and we're able to start David Santos, who has seen some things before. I mean, he's still only a sophomore, but at least he's been out there and has some game reps under his belt.
You know, and he came back and won the job, did Santos. He came back and through his play and preparation, he was able to get back what he earned to start with at the beginning of the year.
Second down to the ground game, and John Davis. Flag on the play. Got two flags on the play. We have three flags on the play.
Illegal substitution, defense, 12 players, 5-yard penalty, still second down.
It's the third time Nebraska's been out of sorts with defensive substitutions today. One of them was declined. Devin Church is now in a tailback. The bar has been set so high defensively at Nebraska. That one's incomplete that you cringe a little bit every time someone asks, are the black shirts back? And this team is so young, it's going to be a while defensively before we really know what's possible for them. But this game has to be a step in the right direction.
Well, you like the potential of the unit. You like the potential of the guys that you see. And, you know, you have some senior ability up front with Ankra coming around, but the majority of this unit is freshmen and sophomores, and they're going to have to play at a higher level as they go along in the Big Ten schedule.
Substitution penalty again for Nebraska. That time, Vincent Valentine couldn't get off the field in time.
Defense, 12 players, 5-yard penalty. Results in the first down.
I can hear talk radio right now. Yeah, we won 39-12, but we had too many guys on the field too many times. Is that being picky?
It's not being picky, but it's at 39-12, it's correctable. You don't want it to have it filter into next week against Purdue. You have another bye week to get organized. I mean, these are just trying to get players on the football field in a game that's out of hand.
Ferguson with the catch in space down to the 40-yard line. That time, Valentine, even after the penalty, was late getting on the field in that personnel situation. That's Bo Pelini told us yesterday that, you know, Valentine goes 6'3", 325. He said, our freshmen don't have body issues, they have mind issues. I thought it was a really interesting comparison that he made. This is Ferguson, and he takes it inside the 15. He compared it to the toughest position to play in football, being quarterback, because you have to be responsible for so much. He said, you know, as a wide receiver, we can just say, you're going to run a go route, or you're going to correct that to a curl. But on defense, you have to know what you're doing, and you all have to work in concert. So if you make the wrong move or you're not disciplined, it not just affects you, it affects the other 10 guys.
Well, you're right. And gap control and eye discipline and moving in the right spot. If one guy is out of sync up front, it's going to create a glaring hole in which you can run the football and take advantage of, or in the secondary when you bust a coverage. So Bo Pelini wants to make sure that this defense, this young defense, continues to learn and continues to grow. And that's why they spent the majority of the off week preparing for the Illini and the offense, because they give you so many sets. You have to be perfect with your alignment. You have to be perfect with your discipline. And they were pretty good today.
Riley O'Toole trying to make something happen for Illinois. Donovan Young inside the 10 to the 9. That will set up third down.
Third down at 6 from the 9-yard line.
The tight end Wilson will come off the field. Here's some defensive subs for Nebraska. O'Toole running the option, keeps it himself, cuts it up, and he needed two more. Four down territory. Afalava with the stop with Rose. Let's be honest here as well. It's a 39-12 game. These are a lot of second and third stringers in the game right now for Nebraska. That's Michael Rose, who is shook up.
Michael's played a nice football game. Another redshirt freshman making an impact on the defensive side of the football. Good outside leverage by Afalava, and then the inside pressure by Michael Rose.
Fourth down and 2 from the 5-yard line.
O'Toole coming off. This is Bailey at quarterback. They have an extra tackle on the right side. That's Flavin. A tight end to that side as well as Lacoste. Unbalanced. Bailey's going to take off with a pulling guard in front, and he is down to the 1, a first down for Illinois.
Nice design that time by offensive coordinator Bill Cubitt. Everything tells you they're going to run to the wide side to the strength of the formation. And Aaron Bailey just taps John Davis, the tight end, going weak, and he runs right behind him.
Quick snap again. Ferguson is in. Touchdown, Illinois. It's a second time from the goal line. They've gone with a quick tempo out of a jumbo formation. Ninth carry of the day for Ferguson results in a score.
And linebacker Santos just tripped over his own feet. He's the guy that's going to fill that hole, and that was an easy walk inside the 5-yard line for 6 points.
Taylor Zaleski. Good. Here's something that's not good. Bo Pelini and John Papuchis. Been working together since Papuchis was a graduate assistant at LSU. And no matter, you know, I think that really illustrates one thing. No matter what the final score would indicate, or what we think, what looks like a dominating Nebraska performance, especially defensively, where they were very good today, especially with a couple of takeaways. Bo Pelini wants better.
Coaches.
And of course, John Papuchis wants better too.
Coaches coach until, you know, there's triple zeros on the scoreboard. And you have to be able to go and be able to make plays defensively, no matter who's out there. And you have to be able to get guys in and out of the football game. And it goes on the players as well. I mean, that responsibility is shared.
Under a minute to go from Lincoln. Nebraska will rattle off its seventh consecutive regular season Big Ten win. Illinois will lose its ninth consecutive. They haven't won since 2011 in a game against Indiana. And they needed a mighty comeback to win that game against the Hoosiers, if I remember correctly. Nebraska will take a knee. You've known Bo Pelini for a long time. What do you think his take is on this team and what they have in store going forward?
Well, I think he's going to like much of this football game. I think the one problem that's going to aggravate him probably tonight and into the week is maybe the substitution problems on defense and maybe just the organizational part of everything. But I believe the way they came out and played football today, offensively, defensively, special teams, they did what they need to do as another building block towards Purdue and then towards the bye week to improve to prepare for the bulk of the Big Ten schedule.
Injured player for the Illini. Looks like Kenny Nelson. Nelson had that big fumble recovery earlier the third quarter. That was Kenny Bell's great catch from 37 yards. It was the highlight offensively for Nebraska today.
Second down and six to the 23-yard line.
You going to give him the title of best hair in the Big Ten?
I think so. I mean, that goes without question.
3 second runoff, clock operator. Set the clock to 30 seconds, please.
10-second runoff for the injured player, under a minute to go. And that will be the football game. 39-19 is our final. Don't forget, we're sending you to Miami next for a big ACC showdown between Georgia Tech and Al Golden's Hurricanes. Kenny Bell with a great catch. Amir Abdullah with another strong game, and Bo Pelini, who's won 71% of his games here at Nebraska, takes the Huskers to 4-1 with Purdue coming up next. Huskers scored on each of their first couple of possessions today. The defense had a pair of takeaways to try and pace Nebraska. Kenny Bell with the highlight catch of the weekend so far in college football. Maybe there's more in store on South Beach. That's it from Nebraska. Coming up on ESPNU, it'll be Georgia Tech and Miami.